Good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Steve Minnick. We begin tonight, though, with a developing story out of Gorham, where crews are still on the scene of a massive three-alarm fire on Newell Street. That is just off the traffic roundabout with routes 202 and 237. And the fire has forced CMP to cut power to thousands of customers. News 8's Jackie Couture joins us live now from the scene with the latest. Jackie?
Well, Steve, it's still a very active scene here at 8 Newell Street. You can see it's very smoky behind me here. This is quite a small residential area, but close to the 202 intersection. So, of course, firefighters are still on scene battling these hot spots. Most of the flames are out. The good news is everybody is safe tonight. The five people who were in the home at the time made it out. Officials say it started just before 8 o'clock in the barn that was connected to the back of the home. The people who live here say once they spotted the fire, it spread to them in a matter of seconds. The flames were so intense it actually melted the power lines off the home, forcing Central Maine Power to cut power to about 5,000 area residents. Most have since been restored. Eddie Warren, who was there at the time, says his girlfriend was the one who spotted the flames. He's crediting her and his buddy Ken Corvin for saving all their lives.
Him busted the front door down because it was so hot, it just melted everything right shut, and he had to open the door. And without him, I'd still be sitting in that room right there sleeping.
The barn was three trees high of flames, and she yelled around, fire, fire, and Eddie was throwing on his prosthetic legs, and I did what I could. I ran to the front door. The screen door opened fine, and the sliding door there, the heat was heating up the metal. It was swelling. It just wouldn't open. It stuck. And I ran out of the house, and if she was 5 seconds behind, the car would have blew up and killed her instantly.
So certainly a terrifying night for them. They are staying with family and friends tonight. The good news is they do have insurance, so they will likely hopefully get most of their belongings back. But for most things should be destroyed at this point. That house is just gutted. About 100 firefighters from 8 surrounding towns responded to this. They did have an issue with water. They tapped out the fire hydrant system, so they ended up having to tank in most of the water from the area. And investigators with the state fire marshal's office are already here on scene. They'll be investigating overnight. They're already allowed to do the interview process at this point, but they have to wait until the scene obviously gets much cooler before they can go inside to try to determine any sort of cause here. We'll have the latest on News 8 this morning. We're live in Gorham. Jackie Couture, News 8.